If you see your friend getting ratchet, if you see your friend getting ratchet, when that beat drop, I need you to get up and hype your best friend up. Hype up, tell her, I said, throw it, throw it, throw it.
Are you blaming us? Are you saying that it's our fault that this happened?
No, I'm not blaming Black America women. I just said that I'm blaming the system. They are victims of the system like the black male.
Well, why do you say that we are castrating you? You say that you want to be the leaders. Okay, well, what about the black professional woman? Are you saying that there should be no black professional woman? Are you trying to deny Black women the right to be creative, the right to function?
We're not asking for you to take a back seat. We're saying that you have got to be astute enough and can view the situation well enough where you just automatically know what your role is and step back. And whenever you want to have that aggressive thing, this is the thing that the young black man today is not going to tolerate. My old man tolerated because he was his old man tolerated. It came up for years and years and years. But today, the young black man is not going to take it. He's going to be out there as a leader.
White America has used black women to keep the black male in his place. And you're still aiding him by saying, well, we're qualified, we want to work, we can help.
Okay, how are you going to reprogram men so that they don't let us take over what's supposed to be their responsibility? And men that I have had dealings with, they are perfectly willing to sit back and let us do anything we want to.
I don't think you have to reprogram men. I think you have to reprogram.
Feminism is killing this country.
Can you be more specific?
Feminism has taught us to hate men and to fear men because capital profits off of my fear as a woman. If I'm afraid of men, they can make a profit off of that. There's a gender war because men are the underdogs right now. Men are the ones being told, you're feared, you're wrong, everything you do is wrong, go make money, don't show emotion, BBP. Women are making a rise to the top. We've over-feminized so much and included women so much, which is great. But we don't have to tear men down to include women.
Do you think that women should carry leadership positions?
No.
Why not?
The answer is not why not. The answer is why would they?
Yeah.
Don't say why not. What is one benefit of women being in leadership positions? There's no benefit.
But and women are advocating for equal.
No. Not all women.
Well, not a lot all of women are advocating for equal, right?
Women who are not smart are advocating for equal.
Why you say that?
Smart women are not doing that. Because women, and this is why we can't be trusted, honestly.
Because women can't be trusted?
Women cannot be trusted. We need rules. We need guidelines. We need a procedure. Don't just give us space talking about go be the leader. That's probably the worst thing you could do for a woman. It's just too much. It's just too much. We can't handle that. So my thing is, Women just hear, I want to be the leader. And all they think about is the glamorous part of it.
Yeah.
Not understanding when things go bad, the leader go down with the ship. The captain go down with the ship. So women, the reason why women can't be trusted as leaders because they only want the fun parts of leadership.
Yeah.
They want the attention. It's really a desire for adoration. They want the adoration of being the leader, but they don't want the consequence of it's your fault when this go left. That's the part they don't want. You know, I find that masculine men, you almost have to force them to not blame themselves. Masculine men blame themselves for everything.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what I'm saying? When something go left, he going to be like, that was me. And you be like, it really wasn't you. He going to take the blame. Women don't go that way. They want to lead. And then when it go left, say, but it wasn't me. No, it was you because you're a leader.
That is
very
true.
See why you shouldn't want that? That's why I don't want
that. That is absolutely true. Mm-hmm. It's funny because even in the conversations that we have off camera, you like, yo, I'm not trying to do what men do at all. Like, that's your sentiment. Like, you don't even have to say it. That's just kind of all on you. You're mm-hmm. just like, yo, mm-hmm. I'm not really trying to get into that. When we straight got down there and we got to the hotel, whatever, checked you in and everything like that, you just chilling in the car. Mm-hmm. Like, hey, let me
living
know when I get out or whatever. It's on
the Somebody wrote me on Instagram, was like, six. You know what I noticed? They were like, six. You be living your best life.
Yeah.
They was like, every time I see you dancing and you having fun, I'm like, you know what? I do be living my best life.
You do. The
I be
entire
having a ball.
Time. And you like, I'm checking on you, like, or I had Rita check on you. I said, Rita, is she good? She's like, Sixth already made friends. Sixth is
friends.
Doing her thing.
They calling me right now. They like, you want to come out? I'm like, I have friends here now. People like me. They fuck with a real nigga for real.
Yeah.
I mean, you cannot help but fuck with a real nigga.
But when you say black men don't take care of their kids and you got two babies, you know how many women I know that have two and three babies daddy and say all three of their babies daddies ain't shit? If you got three babies daddies that ain't shit, don't that mean you ain't shit because you chose them? I mean, if a coach picks a bunch of players or GM in a sports team picks a bunch of players and the team sucks, do you know who they fired? The GM, because he picked them. So ladies, you are the GM of the team that's called your life. And the field they playing on is your pussy. And most of y'all are letting people just wreck and run roughshod over your pussy. Then you want people to feel sorry for the decision you made of who would play on the field, i.e. your pussy. You are the GM of this team. You put these niggas on your field. They fucked it up and you don't.
It took me one time to learn with hurt feelings that my husband doesn't want to be loved like a woman. Men similarly come packaged from the factory wanting three basic things to be nurtured, right? I say keep that man fed. To be respected, it is vitally important that when he comes home, he feels honor from his queen, that he is appreciative of what he does out in the workforce to provide for his family. And then number three, to have really great sex. Men love to feel physically attractive and love physical affection. And not all women, but most women love acts of service, like they take out the trash. Oh my gosh, doing the dishes after, you know, I've had a long day with the kids. Gift giving, like the thought of my husband being somewhere and seeing something, I'm like, oh my gosh, my wife would love this. That makes me feel special. And so I made the horrible decision of one year for his birthday, getting him this herringbone chain that he could wear every day. Like, you know, a chain under his shirt. He wore it once, he wore it twice, and I never saw it after that. Immediately, you know, in my head, I'm like, oh my gosh, he doesn't appreciate me. He doesn't love me. Like, I like spent a lot of money on that. But after I spoke to him, he gave me this analogy that was just beautiful and I was grateful for. He said, babe, spending time with me is special to you, right? I said, absolutely. He said, being next to me and me inviting you to things makes you feel special, right? I said, absolutely. He said, well, Sunday, watching football all day, is that special to you? I said, no, not really. But that doesn't negate